in a way, what is shocking above all of this, too, is that you intervened. You thought there was somebody rogue visiting him.
Absolutely. Almost right from the start, I felt like there was something not quite right with this person that was running the server. He had an avatar that didn't look like a normal gaming sort of avatar.
And an avatar, for anyone who doesn't know, is a little sort of model person.
A picture of who they are.
And it was a model boy the same age,
well,
roughly as...
Yes, and many boys will have their own picture, but this was a boy who looked quite attractive, and he had a pink bow tie, and I just felt like that wasn't an avatar that boys playing, you know, games would actually have. So that alerted me at the beginning.
And you actually spoke to him?
I did. Because the boys were on the server, they were on TeamSpeak. It's a bit like a live Skype program. It's very interactive, and it's a lot of fun. It's really interesting. Breck always had an open door, and I would go in and listen, and I could hear what they were talking about. They were just starting to get a lot of humor between them, and I was quite enjoying it. It was starting to be, a bit more intelligent humor compared to, what you have when you're younger. And, on the outset, it looked, quite interesting because they were socializing. They were friends from Breck's school. They had invited him in, and these boys had been, gaming and socializing for a while in this way.
But in the end, you managed to persuade Breck not to go on talking to him, but it went on in secret.
Well, I actually forbade Breck from talking to him. What happened was Breck's behavior changed, and he started to not follow sort of family rules, and his ideology was changing. And I could tell it was somebody, and I believed it to be Danes, was trying to change all of, the things that we had lived as a family. And Danes was trying to say Breck shouldn't have to do any of those things.
And at this point, you engaged the police.
After I got so upset one day because I had just had enough with Danes trying to tell me how to raise my child and he wouldn't show his face, I called the police on December 17th, 2 months before. I gave 30 minutes of information with his name, his alias, the fact that he had no pictures on any of his sites. He told very, very tall tales that were very unbelievable. He said he was 18, but I thought maybe he was older.
Did they refer you to CEOPS, the Child Protection Agency?
They didn't. I didn't actually hear about CEOPS until after Breck's death. And
that's absolutely unbelievable.
Yeah, I wished I had, contacted them, but
you probably didn't know about them.
I didn't know about them, but now it seems like they're inundated as well.
Yeah, I mean, and that's part of the problem.
Yes.
Now, you're starting a foundation. What's the aim?
Yes. Well, it's the Breck Bednar Memorial Foundation. We've named it in his name because I feel... I can't believe I've lost my gorgeous son. I have to find a way to help other people and other teenagers to understand the dangers of online predators. It's a very real danger. They may seem like your friends, they may have been gaming with your friends, but if these people won't show their face and, even online, it's a great, you should be highly suspicious. And when we were talking earlier, I loved your idea, as if someone online won't actually show their face, then that's it. You can't be friends if you won't show your true self. I did try to see Danes.
The trouble is you could block them, but he can unblock them. I mean, it's so difficult.
Danes was very controlling and manipulative with the boys and Breck in particular, because I saw it and heard it firsthand. And for some reason, Breck was under his spell. Breck was impressed that he was going to learn more about technology. He had a passion for computing.
And this drive to make your foundation, is that getting you through what must be an absolutely ghastly...
It's been an absolutely horrible year, the worst nightmare a mom could ever have. But this is helping, and I hope it can help in the future. There's another element, too, is that we want to ensure that government agencies share information and communicate. Because there's so many stories, once again, where there was, possibly things to look into and they weren't looked into properly. So we need to work on that.
Well, Lorin LaFave, thank you very, very much for coming in.
Yeah, thank you.